Welcome back. This video is for all of those who are eligible to come to Canada. So in this video, I'll be talking about the quarantine plan. It's not that the borders have opened for everyone. This video is only for those who are eligible to come under these prevailing circumstances. And for the eligibility requirements, I've posted a link in the description box, which you can refer. Since this channel is mainly for students as of now, so the students who received the study permit before March 18, 2020 are eligible to come to Canada. So listen to these instructions carefully, because if you do not follow this quarantine plan, then you can be sent back or you will be punished. I'll tell you about everything, what you need to do for your quarantine plan and what will be the consequences if you do not follow the plan. Welcome back. My name is Bani Singh, and if you are new to this channel, then consider subscribing it so that you have the latest information and an edge on studying and settling abroad. Oh, can you hear birds chirping? This bird is so clever, it stopped chirping when I said that. Can you hear it chirping? Never mind, I think you'll hear in the rest. Oh, it just chirped back. So this sound is really amazing, and this is the wonderful trail that I'm sitting in. First, starting with the travel procedure. So you will be made to undergo an examination which will check if you test positive for COVID or not. I think it's more of the symptoms that they will check, and obviously if you show symptoms, they won't allow you to board the flight. So that's one. Now, if you think you are a hotshot in India and you can get away with the rules, then you can get away with the rules only in India, and I think these are rather strict. You can't get through these. But if it's possible for you and you think that you will make it in spite of you showing the symptoms, then there's another challenge for you. So at the port of entry, they will again have your examination, and if you are found to show the symptoms, you will be sent back. So don't act smart, and I think anyone shouldn't travel if someone is showing symptoms. What if there are people? So be aware that you'll have another examination at the port of entry, which would be the airport. And if that initial screening test before boarding the flight wasn't enough, you will have another screening at the port of entry, which would be the airport. So at the airport, you will have your another screening, and if you are showing symptoms, you will be straight away sent back. There would be no concessions for you. So make sure that you are aware of all this and you stay safe and take all the precautions, and also have the screening test before boarding the flight. Now, before talking about what exactly is the quarantine plan, I want to scare you so that you would listen to the quarantine plan carefully and abide by it. So if you do not follow the quarantine plan, then you are bound to be punished, and in the punishments you can be imposed a fine of $750,000. That is a huge amount. Also, you can be put in jail for 6 months, and of course you will be deported back to your home country and will not be allowed to enter Canada for 1 year. So now it's the time to listen to the quarantine plan carefully, and not just listen to it, and actually make that plan so that they won't send you back, so that they know that you have an actual solid plan and you will be allowed to stay in Canada. So when you arrive at the airport, you will be asked to either fill a paper application, or I think there is an app where you have to fill the details of your quarantine plan. So be prepared from your home itself that this is going to be a quarantine plan, so that there you are not clueless as to what to write in the quarantine plan. So the quarantine plan basically means that you have to self-isolate yourself for 14 days, and this implies that you have to have a place here to live that can either be your family or friends, or I'm not particularly sure about this, but I think that this should work. If you do not have any known people here in Canada, then you can show them your Airbnb confirmation that the host has allowed you to stay at their place and will be providing you with all the essential services. Now, the step two of this process, apart from staying at home, obviously is that you cannot travel, you cannot go to public places, and that's not really easy. So the time people land here, they get their SIM card, so you won't be able to get that if you haven't got that from the airport itself. You cannot go out to buy grocery, but there's an easy fix for that. You can always say that you will use Instacart. You will use a home delivery service and you'll get your meals or grocery through that. Another implication is that for the initial 14 days, you can't go job hunting. You cannot step out of your home. You cannot go to public places. You cannot use the public transportation. So you cannot go and drop resumes. Of course, you can apply online, but the chances of getting a job through online application these days are pretty less for part time especially. So you have to make sure that you have someone in Canada that will do all the things for you. So you can say that you are going to live at your relative's place and they will do all the things. They'll buy grocery for you. Even if you do not show symptoms, this is for everyone. You have to self-isolate yourself for the initial 14 days after coming to Canada. Apart from this, the 14-day quarantine plan, also make sure that you abide by all the instructions at the port of entry, that is the airport, and you can show that you have the knowledge how to behave in this scenario. So basic measures like when you are sneezing, so use your elbow to sneeze in and don't sneeze like this, or not even using your hand. So make sure that you do all these things for the safety of other people as well. Also, they might ask you how you're planning to go to your destination, that is the home that you are planning to stay in. So you can tell them that your family or friends are going to pick you up in their car. So this was it. I thought that it's really important to tell that those of you who are eligible have to follow this 14-day quarantine plan and have to have the information ready to give at the time of arrival, so that they know that you are fully equipped to stay in Canada and you will be self-isolating yourself. I hope you liked this video. If you did, then consider liking it, subscribing to my channel Bani Abroad, and also hitting that bell icon. And you can also be my friends on my Instagram handle Bani Abroad and can shoot me your queries. So that's it for the meantime. Until my next video, stay safe and spread love and happiness. Bye. Can you believe cricket in Canada? So these people back there are playing cricket. Let's take you there.